In Your Health Tonight, a Yale study with promising results for patients coping with a medical condition that can lead to hair loss.
And about 7 million Americans and millions worldwide are struggling with that autoimmune disorder. News 8's medical reporter Jocelyn Mementa with more on what this Yale study revealed.
We're talking about alopecia areata. What started with one case several years ago led to a clinical trial at Yale School of Medicine. Researchers gave participants a drug already prescribed for patients with rheumatoid arthritis, and a significant number of them regrew their hair.
A medication prescribed for patients with rheumatoid arthritis could be the lifeline for patients with severe hair loss.
For decades, when we thought there was nothing, there is something, and we now have concrete evidence of that.
Now there's proof that Xeljanz also works to treat alopecia areata, an autoimmune skin disorder with recurring hair loss on the scalp and other areas of the body.
This is truly a whole shift in a disease that creates tremendous despair and depression.
A clinical trial co-designed by dermatologist Dr. Brett King at Yale School of Medicine has significant findings. For 3 months, 66 adults took 5 milligrams of this drug twice a day. Researchers say it appears to stop the immune system attack on the hair follicle. A third of them regrew 50% or more of hair. This woman started with very little, but by the end of this study,
had complete regrowth. Of hair.
Another third, up to 15% of regrowth, like this patient.
Somebody who very clearly is responding but hasn't achieved yet 50% regrowth.
With a third not responding, but even that group had some success.
Some of those patients showed some but weak evidence of hair regrowth. And indeed, when you look at some of those patients, not all of them, but some of those patients in subsequent months, they achieve complete regrowth.
A critical detail?
The longer you have a bald spot or the longer that you are bald, the less likely you are to respond.
Results of longer trials will be released soon. Dr. King is confident of the long-term impact of the treatment.
I suspect that some people will achieve a durable remission and might be able to actually come off of the medications at some point and maintain their hair growth. But I suspect that most people will probably need to continue treatment at some dose to maintain regrowth.
There were no significant side effects. Dr. King says nothing that led to discontinued treatment. Look for the results of the longer trials in the coming weeks. And again, it looks to be even more promising. Jocelyn Mementa, News 8.